Welcome back to the 1988 USA Championships here in Las Vegas. Hugh Millay along with Sean Paul Jenkins. We now enter the middleweight category. 176 is the cutoff weight there. You're looking at 23-year-old John Otswerk from Chicago, who we've seen on previous broadcasts here on ESPN. He came in first place in the middleweights at the Junior Nationals in his hometown of Chicago. And now he comes in fifth place here tonight. A guy with a long look. He comes in at 5'7", 173 tonight.
Just shows you the stiff competition here, Hugh. We got 150 competitors around the United States here. We're looking at the cream of the crop of bodybuilding right here. In any other show, this man probably would have won. But it just goes to show you, I would hate to be a judge tonight. I really would.
He comes in, he attends the Elk Grove Village Police Academy, so combining bodybuilding and enforcing the law in the Chicago area.
Pretty sure that size comes in handy in his line of work.
Sure it does. Been bodybuilding now for about 6 years, won the Illinois Cup back in 1986. So he's had tremendous achievements on the local and regional level, and of course the national level right now, at least Junior Nationals. And then tonight, a fifth place position has to be very pleasing for him.
Structurally, he looks really good here, Hugh. He's got great shape, great muscularity. Bad choice of music, though, here. He's not using his physique to the fullest amount.
John Otswerk leaves the stage. And now we start with some pretty intense music. You're looking now at 25-year-old Stoney Grimes. Been bodybuilding now for 10 years, and the crowd obviously into Stoney's routine. He's got a few fans out there, Sean, and I have to think from a psychological standpoint, that's got to help you a little bit.
It does. When you have people out there cheering, it's infectious. One person cheers, and pretty soon you got a whole crowd. Plus, the choice of music here is really important. Before Stoney even started posing, he had the crowd aroused, and it helps. It really does.
Trained with Lee Labrada, a very successful pro bodybuilder, and of course, he owns his own fitness center. But this guy's whole life is fitness and bodybuilding, and you can see the fruits of his labor right there. And Lee Labrada, not a bad guy to idolize or work out with.
And Lee knows his stuff. Lee has been very successful in the past. Stoney looks really good here. It looks like he's holding just a little bit of water on his back. And like I said, in this competition here, we're nitpicking, and that's the only thing that separates the winners from the losers.
You have to nitpick, because this competition is so high right now. I mean, the intensity.
It is.
And everybody comes in there. I mean, these judges must be looking with magnifying glasses to find out just the difference between these gentlemen.
Well, you have to, and unfortunately, not all these guys can walk away with that title, Mr. USA, but they're all winners out here tonight, Hugh.
Stoney leaves the stage, coming in fourth place in the middleweights. Let's see if Tamara Diarro can catch up with him backstage.
Contestant number 146. Stoney, can we have a second with you? Come on, walk right over here. You own a fitness center?
Yeah.
Does that help you in your training?
Very much so.
How'd you get involved in bodybuilding?
Family, big brother, football player. I just wanted to be a part of got tired of getting picked on.
Well, you did a wonderful job. You sure had the audience out with you tonight.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Thank you, Tamara. And right now, the crowd is rocking to the beat of the music, along with John Sherman out of the Lone Star State. This guy has literally blown away the collegiate competition, winning the collegiate nationals quite handily, also winning the Teenage Texas title. So this guy appears to have it all there, Sean, and coming in third place in the middleweight category.
He does. John only weighs 168 pounds, but to look at him, you swear this man weighs at least 190. He's very thickly muscled. He has great shape. Everything is there. Now, what the judges are looking for in a competition, they're looking for a competitor that has overall balance, great definition, muscularity, the skin tone, the lack of water retention, and then it comes down to comparing each bodybuilder and within each different body part, and it becomes very difficult towards the end here.
John's a sorter at UPS, so and he says every other minute of the day is devoted to bodybuilding. John Sherman leaves the stage, the crowd giving him a nice round of applause. But right behind him, as we continue the competition, the second place finisher in the middleweight category, Anthony Civiletti. And the music is hard. He comes in tonight at 5'2", 172. And this guy we were talking about as we saw him in a prejudging, Sean, he reminds you of a former famous short bodybuilder who is
Danny Padilla. This man is big, thick, and ripped to the bone.
He qualified by winning first place in the middleweight division at the New York State Gold Classic in 1986, but coming in tonight a little over 5'2", very, very thick, very muscular. And as you said, Danny Padilla certainly comes to mind when you look at this gentleman. Tony Civiletti, featured earlier on an edition of Muscle Magazine on ESPN, one of the three amigos out of Rochester, New York, who trains at Samson's Gym. Anthony, a big guy, but certainly one of the bigger guys, and one of the favorites tonight is another middleweight by the name of Kevin McGowan.
I was 18 years old when I decided, hey, this is what I want to do. And I competed in a teenage show. I feel like a fourth, not knowing entirely what I just did it. I didn't know what I was doing. But I was, from that point on, I was hooked. Probably the most important thing I learned is how to listen to my own body as far as the different foods that I, how they respond to me. And the different training aspects that I've tried, what works best for me. I believe, everybody's a little bit different and not everything works for everybody. And I think through keeping a good journal, which I do, I've able to really learn from my mistakes and find out what works for me and what doesn't. For the last 6 months, my training has been very, very consistent. I haven't missed, I've been in the gym every day when I'm supposed to be. And my diet's been a lot stricter. I stayed, I tried to keep my weight down all year and keep my body fat very low, which did make it easier towards the end to really, to get very, very lean. Okay, my job is fairly convenient for my training because I work for a general nutrition center, which is a health food and vitamin store. And I'm the manager, so I can pretty much schedule my training around my job. And I can eat when I have to. And plus, it's related, so it's like I'm never out of the atmosphere. I'm always learning, and I meet a lot of people through my job. I like the sport, and I want to promote the sport, and I want to promote myself. I'd like to make my living from it eventually in some aspect. It's just me against me, It's like nobody, it all depends on me and how disciplined I discipline myself, and I really get into that. It's all up to me. How I look just depends on how dedicated I am, and I have nobody to blame but myself.
Nobody to blame tonight as Kevin McGowan wins the middleweight category and coming in tonight at 5'6", 176, only 25 years old and keeping so lean as he does. You can see he is really ripped tonight, Sean.
He's shredded. Kevin has done everything properly here. He's coming at the top of his weight class. He's got great shape. He's got great proportion. This man is shredded. Look at that back. Thickly muscled. I mean, he's a clean-cut winner. There's no doubt about it.
Clean-cut winner in the middleweight division. He'll be back for the overall pose down to find out who gets the overall title. Leaves the stage tonight with the Mr. USA trophy. But as far as the middleweights go, this guy certainly deserves the first place trophy in the middleweight category. Once again, the cutoff of that 176. McGowan coming in just under that today.
He made a statement earlier that he has no one to blame but himself, and actually the competition takes place within yourself. Right here, what we see on the stage is more or less the presentation, because no one gets up in the morning but you. And I mean, it's easy to walk away from the gym or cheat on your diet. So I mean, the only person you have to compete against is yourself, dude.
Kevin McGowan, who used to compete as a light heavy, obviously getting down now to the middleweight category, coming in looking very, very big. And certainly, as you've mentioned before, just ripped to shreds right here. Maybe the leanest guy we've seen on stage tonight.
Well, as of yet, he is the best we've seen so far.
We will continue from Las Vegas with the 1988 USA Championships. Next up, the light heavyweight. Stay with us. And we welcome you back to the 1988 Men's USA Championships. Hugh Millay and Sean Paul Jenkins, and we now get into the semi-big boys, I guess you'd call them. The light heavyweight class, cutoff weight is 198. You're looking now at the fifth place finisher in that category, Glenn Kinnear.
This man looks good, Hugh. This is a progressive sport, and I'm telling you, each year these guys are getting bigger and better every year. I'm just glad I turned pro when I did, Hugh.
This man over the years has been dominating some local and regional shows, but one of the big thing he is really proud of is his leg development. He's a gym owner out of Phoenix, and the back looks good, but when you get a shot at those legs, I think people know what we're talking about.
But overall, he looks really good. And like we stated before, this is a tough competition here. And any of these men could win at any time, but it comes down to nitpicking. It really does.
Strategy for your final posing routine here. I mean, there's things that you want to show and there's things you want to hide. Do you plan this in the gym? I mean, obviously you're happy with some body parts and not with others.
Well, as you go along, everything fills out, but some body parts do grow slower than others. So while creating your posing routine, you want to highlight your strong body parts and try to hide the weak ones. Unfortunately, there are some body parts you can't hide.
Glenn Kinnear leaves the stage, coming right up right behind him, Benny Poda. And this is certainly the most vocal competitor as far as the audience goes. Benny's been around a long time. Sean, you got a few stories you want to relate to us?
Well, Benny has a lot of stories within himself. They call this one the Beast from the East. Benny is from, Pittsburgh. This man is thick. I've seen this man. This man should be a powerlifter. He could be an Olympic powerlifter with some of the weight that he plays around with in the gym.
He comes in, the crowd really into a qualified first place overall in the 86 West Coast Championships. He's a trainer of movie stars and other people in the Hollywood scene, now residing in Hollywood, California. I mean, with kind of a strange posing routine, the back looks fantastic, but certainly not the traditional shots here for Benny.
Well, Benny is a powerful person. He has a powerful personality, and he exhibits that while he's posing. That's all Benny is power, sheer power. Only thing I would like to say to Benny is, pose the body, not the face.
You say that to him. You say that to him in person. Let's see if Tamara can catch up with Benny backstage.
Here he comes, the Beast from the East. Contestant 206. Hi, Benny. Can we have a word with you?
Sure.
Right over here, sir. You have an actual fan section out there.
It sounded like it, didn't it?
Yeah, it sounded like it looked like it, too, with those T-shirts.
Did you see those T-shirts? What do you think of those? I bought all those this morning.
And you got...
Pass them out to people on the street, told them to come.
I don't think so. There's someone pretty special wearing those T-shirts.
Who's that?
A karate guy you're training.
Bruce Lee? No, he's dead. Chuck Norris.
You're right. Chuck Norris is here with his entourage of people, an onslaught of people taking care of you tonight.
Yeah, they are. Good friends of mine. They take care of me. They're taking care of me in a lot of ways. Very good people. My family. I can call them a family.
Well, you did a great job tonight, and good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Back to more competition.
Thank you, Tamara. We talk about the emergence or the development of a bodybuilder. This man has developed quite well over the years. You're looking at Frank Santoriello from New Jersey, and who competed in 86 as a middleweight, now as a light heavyweight. Certainly one of the more massive bodybuilders taking the stage tonight.
This man has great shape. Not alone just to be big, he has great aesthetic shape here, which is something is more genetic than that you can really do in the gym. You have to be born this way.
Big. Awesome. Big man, 5'6", coming in tonight at just under the limit at 198, training at the Powerhouse Gym in Cincinnati under the direction of John Perillo, who has a lot of gentlemen he trains, and Frank may be his star pupil right now. And at age 22, what a phenomenal future this gentleman has. Frank Santoriello from New Jersey, coming in third in the light heavyweights. We'll continue with more from the USA Championships from Las Vegas after this. Welcome back. We continue here at the 1988 USA Championships in Vegas, and light heavyweight division continues with Ronnie Schweier, 5'9", 198. Comes in with a tremendous physique and a very pleasant-looking gentleman, a graduate of TCU. Quickly, a critique on Ronnie, John.
Great lines. Muscles flow together very well. Looks like this guy's in great shape here. Kind of reminds me of a young Bob Paris. Pose is really smooth.
When he was very young, his mother would teach him ballet, so obviously the graceful way he poses is right now on stage is certainly the most graceful we've seen here tonight.
Yeah.
Tremendous, and he's got a physique to match up pretty well.
He looks really good. Like I stated before, you can work for a long time in the gym, but your body will only do what it was meant to do. Genetically, this man is gifted. Everything flows together well. He has no lagging body parts. I mean, great future ahead of this guy.
He's won the Collegiate Nationals back in 1987, also won Mr. Texas, and won that back in 1986. And, of course, he's a gentleman with great success on the regional and statewide level, and, of course, nationally with winning the collegiates. But just the look of this gentleman, and you mentioned the name Bob Parris, and certainly has that aesthetic feel about him that he certainly enjoys, that this is not just a competition, he's like an art form.
That's it, it is. This part of bodybuilding is stage presentation here, and I can't emphasize this so much. This is a whole round, and a round is a lot in a show that's so tightly webbed here.
An awesome-looking Ronnie Schweier, finishing up much like he started, very impressively, a tremendous posing routine, coming in second in the light heavies. Another impressive body at 198 would be Ronald Janvier. We caught up with him in the gym before the competition.
I've been competitive bodybuilding now for 5 years. I started as a teenager when I was 19 in 1983, competing as a teenager in Connecticut, Stamford, Connecticut. After I graduated high school, then I met Carlo Bersi from Bridgeport, Connecticut, who got me started on a program with proper training, and he really got me going onto bodybuilding. I trained and not, you know, kept in mind maybe I might compete. And then I really saw the competition and said, well, I could be beating these guys. And I said, well, like, that was it. And I had a full focus from the year before the USA till this year. I had my mind set on this year, and I trained for a whole year preparing my mind and everything. You know, choreography, everything I prepared for that 1 year of the USA. So it's a matter of concentration and the one contest that I really focused on. I would like to peak at my amateur level, as so that means going to nationals and winning universe. And going into the pro, I like to eventually make some money out of the sport, you know. Look at yourself and see what you have and use that as your asset, and don't get discouraged. Because there's a lot of competition out there, and you know, sooner or later your chance will arrive.
There he is, Ronald Janvier, on stage, and I guess he'd get the comeback award. Here's a guy who actually collapsed this morning after prejudging, after working so hard to lose all his water, taking some diuretics. He actually collapsed, and the prejudging was actually halted for some 30 minutes, Sean, really working to get all that water out of his system.
The sacrifices we make for this sport, Hugh, is enormous. I mean, there's only one way to understand it, and that's to compete in the show. You want to show up at your best here, and you want to use everything that you possibly can to get the edge.
The crowd is certainly reacting to, obviously, the glute shot here, Sean, and certainly the most impressive back leg we've seen, I think, in a show.
Well, this man is a standout right here, Hugh. He's thickly muscled, he's ripped to the bone, he's posing well. I mean, there are no weak body parts on him at all.
And once again, he'll be back for the overall pose down. The issue of the Mr. USA still must be decided. And looking at this guy in this condition, you have to feel that it'd be very tough to beat.
I'd say so. I really would.
24-year-old Ronald Janvier. And the crowd has been yelling since he took the stage. A tremendous posing routine. And if we had a crowd meter here at the Sands, this gentleman so far would probably get the nod, but he still must contend with the next weight category, the always impressive heavyweights, as Ronald leaves the stage. And, of course, the three other division winners will also be taking the stage for the overall. But next up, it's the big boys, the heavyweights. They come out for their initial lineup, and the individual posing routines are next from Las Vegas. We'll continue the 1988 USA Championships. Stay with us. It's coming next.